Hello fellow thinkers, in this video I will address the Sinai map, which is a very interesting map. It's a triangular map which is very similar in configuration to the jungle map or the advanced to the Rhine map, in the sense that each side has a cap which naturally belongs to them. B for red, C for green, but you notice that these two caps are not that close to each spawn, and they are not too far from each other, so which means that it's not guaranteed that red will keep B or green will keep C. And again, you have the same thing on the jungle or advance to the Rhine, and quite far away, you have an isolated cap which can be accessed by another set of spawns. And the reason why these triangular maps are very interesting, there are quite very few in the game, but they are very interesting in the sense that at the end of the day, you need at least two caps to win the game. And the team will have in real time to decide to focus on capturing the enemy cap, that is ultimately winning the game with at least B and C, or defending their cap, hoping that essentially the fight in B and C is a stalemate, and then ensure that A is captured by the team. So that ultimately you will win by keeping your cap and holding A. So that means that that what you will do will depend on what your team and the other team is doing. If you see that it's a stalemate between B and C, and that both teams have a lot of forces on B and C, and that it's very unlikely that one will overcome the other, that means that A becomes the most important cap. On the contrary, if you see that the enemy team has a lot of force, I've seen teams with something like half of their forces around A. So that means that now their cap is probably vulnerable, and then you have essentially to forget about A and try to actually capture ultimately B and C. So it's really a very interesting map, and I think that Gajin should make more of these triangular maps instead of the usual vertical or horizontal maps where the three caps are aligned either at equal distance from the two spawns, or aligned essentially between the two spawns. This kind of maps are really much richer. So let me address the access to A first. So very often, but not systematically, it depends also if I play alone or in squad, but very often I'm going to A because my hope is that, and which happens quite often, is that actually indeed the battle on B and C is a stalemate. My side will keep their cap, the enemy will keep their cap, and ultimately the battle will be decided on A. Also, capping A early allows you to start the ticket bleed. But like on jungle, like I mentioned on jungle, another advantage to start in A is actually related to the fact that once you are on A, you have actually several options, including actually helping for the fight of B and C, that is either helping defending your cap or helping even attacking the enemy cap. So let's address now the approach of A. So my advice from the green side is that you start by going to the west before coming down. A is in the lower ground, so it's actually pretty well covered. So first start to the west and then come down. The idea is to use these rocks to protect yourself from the campers here, and the terrain will give you some cover, whereas a more direct approach can be pretty dangerous. You will be very often sniped when you will be in this area. From the right side, it's the same. You start to the west. Again, use the cover of these rocks. You can actually even stop behind these rocks and then plunge toward there. So from the green side, you have to be careful of tanks which would be here, and from the red side, you have to be careful, especially of red tanks which would be here, green tanks which would be here. Which actually means, as we will see, that these positions here is a very good position, this approach here for the red tanks, and definitely at least one tank should be here to put pressure on A or to cover A if the green side has captured it, or at least to prevent red tanks to come on A. This position is actually pretty good. If the enemy is in force on A, so my advice is that if you see that you have already enough forces on A, don't spawn later toward A. The reason for that is that if very often if a team has really too many forces around A, they will lose their cap, and then actually their spawn will be in danger and will be very hard to retake their cap. And so essentially, the enemy will control this area and will win the game just because they control two caps. Let me address the fight in this area. So we've seen in the beginning of the game, a few tanks from both teams should fast cap their respective cap, but honestly, it's not a very good position to stay around the two caps, especially for the greens, for the red side. Staying in this area is essentially guaranteed death just a few minutes after the battle. So let me point to the interesting positions and very important position. One of the most important will be this rock for both sides. It will give you a very good shooting angle toward B, actually, toward tanks around B. Remember that most of the buildings in all this area can be penetrated. But also for the green side, it will give you an angle to the east side of the exit of the red spawn, and even if you peek a bit, but that can be obviously a bit dangerous, you can actually cover this entire area. So that obviously, to prevent that, the red tanks in the beginning of the game should really come and on the other side of this rock to put pressure on the green tanks. Very often, if one side completely neglects, especially the red side completely neglects this side of the rocks, that can be very dangerous. Let me mention that for the green side, there is also this rock and this lower terrain here, but which I find less interesting. But actually, on this map, this area here with these three mountains is a very interesting area, which allows you actually to Bon, very effective flanking, in particular in RB. So let me mention that actually once you have capped A, as I will show in the replay, you can actually very often move toward this area. But in the early spawn, or even later in the game, both teams should try actually to flank in this area to first offer another shooting angle, in particular to defend your cap, but also to put pressure on the enemy cap. So for the red tanks, my advice is that you really go this way. So you can either put, so you can obviously exploit this little mountain here, or actually put pressure in this area, even push to here, and then push to here, and even put a lot of pressure to see. You have a lot of cover, small rocks, small area where you can actually have a very good cover from almost everywhere, and where you can have very effective shooting angles. From the green side, it's the same. You go this way. You can fight the red tanks in this area. You can come in this area, where again, as you will see in the replay, you can find surprisingly good cover, despite being in extremely aggressive positions. So this fight in this area really makes the battle interesting and is very often underexploited, in particular in arcade. It's more exploited in RB, but even in arcade, it's putting pressure by coming for the green side from here, or by the red side from here, is a very good way to break the stalemate, which very often happens between B and C. Especially if the two teams have enough tanks, let's say three tanks on both sides of the rocks, essentially you have a stalemate. And of course, to resolve this stalemate, either you have to capture A, but if the enemy has good positions on A, an alternative is actually to put pressure on the enemy cap. Let me mention that currently this map is the same in RB. Before, the RB map was larger, with sniping hills on the east. So the map was interesting, but the aspect of the map that I didn't like is that some of the sniping spots were so effective that essentially this area of the map could not be exploited. It was simply too dangerous. B was actually in this area, and A in this area, and B was essentially so dangerous because of the snipers. So now the maps are the same in Arcane and RB, and the gameplay is actually very similar, except that in RB, I think that people they are a bit more to exploit this area than in Arcade, but honestly, it can be also very effective in Arcade. So let me just summarize. This triangular map is really important, interesting in the sense that both teams will have to decide, and the situation may actually evolve during the game. So decide whether ultimately they want to push for the enemy cap and ultimately control B and C, or essentially defend their cap, so preserve a stalemate between the two teams on B and C, and obviously then put a lot of pressure on A and capture A. And depending on how the situation evolves, you have to adapt and maybe change your objective. And that's really what makes this map very interesting. Again, like Advance to the Rhine or Jungle. And let me mention that, like Advance in the to the Rhine, which I will present in a future video, and Jungle that I have also addressed, the area between the two caps and the isolated caps, this area is actually a very interesting play game, and which definitely you should exploit. But again, on this map, I really insist on the fact that this rock plays a very important role, and that none of the team, and especially not Red, should neglect this rock. All right, so let me move to the replay. So I didn't play this map for quite a long time. So when I saw it, I say, yes, I will make a video for it. I have now treated a large fraction of the maps, so obviously the new maps will come a bit more slowly. And you see the pretty safe approach to A, even if you have campers. It happens that during this battle there was not too many enemy campers. And my advice is that you come in front to reduce the angle, the viewing angle of campers, which would be on the other side. And it goes the same for Red. And since it seems that in the beginning of the game the enemy is not putting a lot of pressure on A, deciding to actually help a bit between B and C, and especially help with these enemy tanks which are coming in this area, which is a good move. They actually killed one guy which was in a bad position around B and A. So snipe, let me, I didn't mention, but actually sniping, let me stop just a minute. So here, by the way, there was a quite nice move of this BMP1. But let me mention that sniping in this area, again, is not very effective. This position, or this green position here, or actually exploiting correctly this rock is much more effective, and actually leads to a much more interesting gameplay. The camping position here and here are just bad, and it's not only bad, but it's also a boring gameplay. There are so many things to do on this map, possible things to do, and even if you want to have a quite static game, my advice is that you really exploit these rocks or this area, or that you are a bit more aggressive and go to the east. I didn't mention that, but what this BMP is doing right now is pretty nice. So here I'm facing a SU-1254, which is a tank which I actually like very much, which is very underrated, and I'm spending a bit too much time to kill it, and unfortunately I'm seeing a bit too late that this guy gets help, and my first tank dies very quickly. See, was not a good start. Now my goal is actually to show you a bit how you can be aggressive by going toward B and by exploiting the terrain in this area. So here there is you see that none of the team have exploited this rock, which is honestly a mistake. This position for green is less powerful than this position, and especially you have a much better view on enemy tanks, which would be on B. So you see, I approach. First, I get my revenge on the M46, which killed me. So all this area is a bit tricky because you have hills, which seems very small, but you actually need a very good gun depression to shoot above them. Here I tried to peek, but this SU-122 was fully awakened. So let me accelerate. Since I wanted to make a video, I'm trying to push a bit along the mountain, and you will see a few very good locations which can be exploited in arcade but also in RB. See, so this position, but of course you have to be aware of tanks in this area also. It's important to clean this area, but I trust my team to do it. My goal was to put a bit of pressure on B. And now I decide to exploit the reload time of this T-34 and the time that we will have to repair to surprise the tank on my left. MX-30, which was not really following what was happening. Even if he didn't see me on the map, he should have heard me shooting. And again, here, look at the disposition. You see, the disposition is actually pretty devilish in RB. It's very well covered. And is an extremely good flanking position to cover the almost the exit of the enemy spawn, but also a very good defensive power if the position, if the enemy is putting pressure on C, if red side puts pressure on C. So here I want to kill this T-34 because he's blocking my advance to B. And you can see this position. Which can surprise a lot of enemies. In RB obviously, but you see even in arcade. And really let me mention that you have the similar kind of positions around here for the red side. So you see that the approach of B, if you need, was not really needed in this battle, despite the fact that we are actually losing A. But if you really need urgently to cap B or to put pressure on B, you see that instead of coming from the west, from the east, coming from the west can be extremely effective. Sorry. So the enemy almost ran out of tickets. Uh, since they have less than 100 tickets, I mean, actually, have the final winning kill just before we actually cap the zone. So, and thank you for watching. As you see, the enemy ran out of tickets before the zone was captured. So I thank you for watching. Let me briefly recapitulate. First, the approach of A exploiting this rock, the importance of this rock, and the very interesting fight that you can have around these three mountains, approaching from here from the red side or from here from the green side, which allows you to either help your team defend your cap or put pressure on the enemy cap. But again, what you should do in this area will strongly depend on what's happening on A and conversely. So I thank you for watching. I invite you also to watch my other videos on the other maps in the same playlist and the two tutorials on the forum. The links are in the description. Thank you, see you on the battlefield, à bientôt sur le champ de bataille.